I'm Mike Hickey. I'm guitar tech with Joe Bonamassa, part of the Bonamafia out here. We're touring around the United States. And I'm in charge of taking care of the used guitars. We don't like to use anything new, so I'm currently in my hand. I have the 1959 Gibson Les Paul Standard, known as the Skinnerburst, which is a real favorite of all the kids and all the chicks. So, really beautiful guitar. We like to use this on quite a few different songs, blues and rock songs. It's just a real rock machine, very rare as well. And we like to take the rare guitars out and use them in concert as opposed to storing them in a vault somewhere. So that's kind of fun. And I'll show you a couple other ones. Always lock them in so you don't lose your job. This one here is another friend of ours called Carmelita, also known as the Claw. This is another 1959 Gibson Les Paul Standard. And it's a great sounding guitar. We're really lucky to have yet another specimen from 59 out with us. Tonight it'll be used for four songs, Slow Gin being one of them, a real barn burner. And the Ballad of John Henry is a favorite for this guitar because there's a lot of fretboard slaying going on in that one. So we like to make sure that there's something from 59 around for that. So this is a real cool one named Carmelita. This is a hardtail Strat, no tremolo. Don't need it, don't want to go out of tune anyway. It's nice and beat up, nice and fun. So we have that one twanging away. And myself, I'll be tuning all the guitars before a show. I'll tune all the guitars. I'll restring a bunch of them or not, depending on what other fun things. Like, I might miss out on all that fun work and go guitar shopping, which is, you know, that's part of the job description too. So we get a car and we got a list, and it's like our mini tour within the tour. And we just try to find, we want to find old junk. We like antiques and guitars, used guitars, you know, these beat up things from the 50s and the early 60s. They're really fun to look for. And tube amps and old signs, advertising signs. It's a lot of fun. I'm restringing a 1955 hardtail Fender Stratocaster using a patented stringing technique created by a guitar tech amp builder named Cesar Diaz. And basically, you take the string, you find the post that it's gonna go in, and you go one, two and a half posts, cut the string, jam it down in there, the old Poussin tuners, and you should end up with a perfectly wrapped, I think it'll be like three wraps around the top there, one, two, three. Thanks to Cesar Diaz for that. It's rocket science. All right, so this is what we're running down here. It's the Joe Bonamassa signature Crybaby Wah-Wah by Dunlop. And it's got what they call a halo inductor, which is an old school way of making a wah-wah. And so from the guitar, plugs into the wah, then into our Way Huge by George Tripps, overrated special. And that's just a little boost, and it has a little mid-range curve, so you can just bring out a certain frequency. And that goes to four amps back here, which are split with some cool little boxes back there. So this is the wah. Classic, you know, what everybody likes. And then the difference between boosted and unboosted is basically, here's unboosted. Just adds a little more grit so you can get a little more sustain. And some hiss. Not much though, it's pretty quiet. And we just power them with batteries, because batteries don't hum. And normally when you have a bunch of pedals and things like this one, this here is for the acoustic guitar. And this is a power supply that can power, it could power all this stuff too. And we just plug the acoustic into this, and that's a little bit of a preamp direct box thing, and that just goes straight out to the PA and gets the acoustic guitars out to the people who are paying to hear it.
I'm about to tape down the set list. It's the all-important item to keep the show flowing smoothly. One time at the Pink Pop Festival, I forgot. So I had to run out and save the day by putting down the set list for Joe Bonamassa so he wouldn't forget. And here's another thing, kids. If you want to save your production team money, tear your tape down the middle. You're using half the amount of tape for something you're going to throw away anyhow.